Welcome back to the shop, and today I've got a couple of new tools that got here, and I'm pretty excited because I want to get back into the Anvil project. There we go. That's a good start. So, finally got around to ordering an R-8 Collet. On this particular R-8 collet is set to 12 millimeter, as I have quite a few 12 millimeter endomills, and I'm pretty excited to have this set up because I've got two operations, one with the end mill and one with the face mill, which is over there somewhere, to get to today. So I'm kind of excited about that. Let's get right to it. As much fun as talking is. Not sure how much people are going to be able to make out here, but I'm going to insert the end mill. And in order to do that, this drawbar needs to come up and out of the way. And I probably should have planned this, but planning, who really does that? All right. Got the drill chuck out of there. And as much fun as using the ER40. So the ER40 is my previous collet setup, and I've been trying to get hold of the R8 collet for quite some time, but these things aren't really all that inexpensive. So either way, we're going with the R8 collet today in conjunction with the 12 millimeter. Okay. Yeah, I'm pretty excited about this whole kit and caboodle here. Like, you guys might not be excited about it, but I sure am. All right, now that I've got the tool set up, I suppose it's time to set the other camera up to accommodate some photos of the milling process. Well, the last time I had to set it up on this chair to prevent from vibration being a huge issue. So we'll see how that works out, and I'll see you in a few minutes on the mill.
Did you lose? I promise to be above board. I didn't plan on doing, but whatever. Oh shit! Don't worry, something. Let's use this slice then. Down quite a bit for this. So right now we're at 800 something, so let's figure out what speed we need to be at. So I can hit that with 4 and 7. 7 and 4. Seven. We're at 465 RPM, and according to the calculation, 475, so we should be all right.
Okay, so
back to the face mill. Let's try to get this organized now.
Alrighty, a little bit of work later. I didn't realize that this type of collet body existed when I bought the lathe. So the R8 in junction with the 12 millimeter, and this is what I was using. Let's see if I can get it out of the vise. This is what I was using before, the ER40. So the stick out difference is amazing. So you like, I'm however many, like 4 inches lower with this one than I was with this one. So these are the way to go. They're much more stable. So with this mill anyway, with the R8 collets for the 12 millimeter. So super pleased about that. and everything's working properly. So I got this face nice and even on the bottom, got some blah blah blah, and then these pieces are what I was talking about, and I wasn't sure how it was going to work out. I'm not sure if I'll do it on any of the anvils that I'm going to be producing, but for this one, at least it provided proof of concept, if nothing else, and how difficult something like that would actually be. And I'm certain that an end mill was not the best way to do that, but it's the tool I chose. So this is for the other than the, I think I'm gonna drill a half inch hole up here, kind of to mimic a hardy hole, On a traditional anvil, I suppose. But for now, this project could be considered finished enough. And I'm not sure what's up next on the list of things to do, but it's nothing important. So take a minute, like and subscribe, and until next time, I'll see you then.